In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. May the peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the goodness of the Holy Spirit be with you. We prepare our hearts to celebrate the sacred mysteries as we ask forgiveness for our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all, by pardoning and showing mercy, Bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord of hosts, there shall yet come peoples, the inhabitants of many cities, and the inhabitants of one city, who shall approach one another and say, come, let us go to implore the favor of the Lord. And I too will go to seek the Lord. Many peoples and strong nations shall come to seek the Lord of hosts in Jerusalem and to implore the favor of the Lord. Many, thus says the Lord of hosts, in those days 10 men of every nationality speaking different tongues shall take hold, yes, take hold of every Jew by the edge of his garment and say, let us go with you, for we have heard that God is with you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm, God is with us. God is with us. His foundation upon the holy mountains the Lord loves, the gates of Zion, more than any dwelling of Jacob. Glorious things are said of you, O city of God. God is with us. I tell of Egypt and Babylon among those that know the Lord, of Philistia, Tyre, Ethiopia. This man was born there, and of Zion they shall say, one and all were born in her, and he who has established her is the Most High God. God is with us. They shall note when the peoples are enrolled, this man was born there, and all shall sing in their festive dance. My home is within you. God is with us. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord, the Son of Man came to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the days for Jesus to be taken up were fulfilled, he resolutely determined to journey to Jerusalem. And he sent messengers ahead of him. On the way, they entered a Samaritan village to prepare for his reception there, but they would not welcome him because the destination of his journey was Jerusalem. When the disciples, James and John, saw this, they asked, "Lord, you want us to call down fire from heaven to consume them?" Jesus turned and rebuked them, and they journeyed to another village. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Very powerful words that are spoken of Jesus, resolutely determined to journey to Jerusalem. In a sense, he's determined to fulfill the whole purpose of why he came, and that is suffering death, that our sins may be washed by the blood of the cross. No surprise that the Samaritans are rejecting him, because from the moment he was born, there was rejection, and that rejection continues right up to this very moment. The sons of thunder, James and John, wanted to give the Samaritans a bloody nose, beat them up, call down fire from heaven to destroy them, and Jesus rebukes them. And Jesus rebukes us. How often Jesus is rejected, and what do we want to do? We want to give them bloody noses. Our life becomes filled with anger and rage and concern and fear. And what does Jesus do? He keeps his focus on doing God's will. And so that is the answer for us in our world, which is so topsy-turvy, totally upside down. Good is bad, bad is good. And we want to punch people in the nose. But yet we thrive on listening to all the terrible news. Three things we need to do: be obedient to the church, by living the sacraments, keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, and to practice our faith in loving God and loving our enemies. If we find ourselves wanting to punch somebody in the nose, we need to do what Jesus did, and that is rebuke that negativity and keep our eyes fixed on the will of God. That is when we will have peace. The battle that is going on in our world today is not between common sense and foolishness. It is between the world of God and the world of the devil. And punching anybody in the nose just feeds the devil. May we grow by keeping our hearts open and doing God's will today, tomorrow, and until we breathe our last. So in confidence we rise, and let us pray.
For all members of the church, may the Holy Spirit help us make a joyful and fruitful witness to the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peoples of every nation, may we all be drawn into the light of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are brokenhearted over the loss of a loved one, may they feel God's healing love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, may we be given humility to hear God's words and the grace to follow where he leads. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the light of faith, may Christ lead them to new life with the Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in the vocations to the priesthood, religious life, holy marriage, permanent diaconate, and single life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in public office, that they may be inspired by the Holy Spirit to serve and protect all life from conception to natural death, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those remembered in our prayer petition thank you book, that through God's everlasting love, they will receive the help they need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Phila Antononia, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, in your generosity, you have sent us the gift of your Son, Jesus. May we place our trust and hope in him. We ask this in all our needs through Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name for our good and good of all his holy church. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, Jesus humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, Jesus freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels, archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host and powers of heaven, we give you praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word. The body of Christ. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen. The fields are and summer days are few. Green fields have turned to gold. The time is here for the harvesting, for gathering home into barns. The is plenty, laborers are few. Come with me into the fields. Your arms may grow weary, your shoes will wear thin. Come with me into the fields.
The sea. Them. The reaping will not be their care.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind, body, and soul, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits
who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. Our Lady of Good Success, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in God's peace.
Thanks be to God.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine. Novena to St. Anthony, O glorious St. Anthony, safe refuge of the afflicted and distressed, who by a miraculous revelation has directed all those who seek aid to come to thy altar with the promise that whoever visits it for 9 consecutive Tuesdays and there piously invokes thee, will fill the power of thy intercession. I, a poor sinner, encouraged by this promise, come to thee, O powerful saint, and with a firm hope I implore thy aid, thy protection, thy counsel, and thy blessing. Obtain for me, I beseech thee, my request in this necessity. But if it should be opposed to the will of God and the welfare of my soul, obtain for me such other graces as shall be conducive through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Pray for us, O blessed Anthony. Let us pray, Almighty and Eternal God, who didst glorify thy faithful confessor Anthony with the perpetual gift of working miracles, graciously grant that what we confidently seek through his merits, we may surely receive through his intercession. To the infant Jesus in the arms of Saint Anthony, O Jesus, my Savior, who didst vouchsafe to appear to Saint Anthony in the form of an infant, I implore thee, through the love thou didst bear to this saint when he dwelt on earth, and which thou bearest to him in heaven, graciously hear my prayer and assist me in my necessity, who livest and reignest world without end. Saint Anthony, our patron and our advocate. Saint Anthony, powerful in word and work. Saint Anthony, attentive to those who invoke thee. Saint Anthony, glory of the church and honor of the Franciscan order. Saint Anthony, whom the infant Jesus so much loved and honored. Through the intercession of Saint Anthony, whose relic I hold, may be blessed today and always. In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.